සභාව කල් තැබීම ගරු සබාන ඇතුමා.
පාලිමේන්තුව හෙට උදේ 10 මාරවත් එක්.
කල් තබන අවස්ථාවේ යෝජනා මුජිබා රව මන්තුමා.
ස්තුතියි. Honorable Chairperson MP, situation in the Middle East, the Arab uprising which started in December 2010 in Tunisia by the end of February 2012. Long-standing rulers had been forced from power in Tunisia, Egypt, Libya and Yemen. Civil uprising had erupted in Bahrain and Syria. Protests had broken out in dozen Arab countries. Except for Tunisia, the Arab people's cries and struggles for freedom and democracy have either been brutally suppressed or have resulted in civil war involving major global and regional powers. The price has been paid mostly by the civilians, ordinary people whose lives have been devastated. The situation in the Middle East has rarely been as desperate as it is today. We see large-scale civilian suffering in Syria, Yemen, Iraq and Palestine. 2 weeks ago, in briefing to the Security Council under the Secretary General for Humanitarian Affairs, Stephen O'Brien said, the suffering in Aleppo, one Syria
please.
Commercial...
Garu, Anand Kumar Sirimantma Mulasana Garna.
The suffering in Aleppo, one Syria commercial epicenter, was the apex of horror. The situation in Syria continues to be one of unspeakable suffering for the Syrian people, who are killed, forced to survive under bombs or flee to less ravaged areas. Estimate range from 250,000 to 500,000 killed in the 5-year-old Syrian war. The ongoing civil war has created more than 4.8 million Syrian refugees dispersed in Egypt, Iraq, Jordan, Lebanon, and Turkey, and 6.6 million internally displaced persons as of 2015. Syria has 160,000 stateless persons as of 2015. UN humanitarian agencies and partners are currently operating within a very large humanitarian response plan, which calls for $3.2 billion in funding, and of which just 33% has been received as of August. In this hour of urgency and need, we as the Sri Lankan government should stand by the ordinary Syrian people and call on the international community to bring halt to the violence and gross violation of human rights that is taking place in the Middle East, especially in Syria. It is unfortunate that recent talks between the United States and Russia on Syria have failed to bring about positive results. I propose that this House call on the global powers and the international community to take immediate steps to address the urgent humanitarian situation and get all parties of the conflict agrees to peaceful resolution to the conflict, which ensure freedom, justice and prosperity to the Syrian people. Thank you very much.
Presiding Member, I actually must thank Honorable Mujib Rahman for bringing this motion at a time like this. So many thousands and thousands of children are homeless today. There are so many thousands of women who are without their husbands, killed by this, you must say, bloody war. And I would like to go back to my history. When you think of all the Middle East countries, they were actually very peaceful. The countries are rich. They were helping almost all the poor countries. They haven't any problems. They had great leaders. Now, take for instance, people like Gaddafi, late Gaddafi, Saddam Hussein, and Hafiz al-Assad. The country was doing very well. people were looked after very well, and they were helping almost all the poor countries. But today, what is the position? In 1976, I can remember, we had the Non-Aligned Conference in Sri Lanka. Almost all the Middle East countries, Arab countries, leaders came to, and they took part in that conference. And after that, they started helping us by providing employment to our youths. And today, I must say, it is from the Middle East countries, we get the maximum amount of foreign exchange. This was the situation earlier on. Now, Saddam Hussein, I can remember, they are the big countries who were against them. They said they were having mass destructive weapons. The war started there, organized by people against him. But once the war was over, once he was killed, where was his mass destructive weapons? Where were his planes? Now, after that, they started the Muammar Gaddafi. Same problem. But what finally happened was they took away their oil. They took away their wealth. And today, those countries are suffering today. Hafiz al-Azhar was one of the best leaders in the Arab countries. What happened? They got rid of him. Today, this country is suffering. Who are suffering? Poor people. They are homeless. As the Honorable Member quoted, millions of people. Now, when you take Syrian war, 5,000 people have been killed. Four million refugees in adjoining countries, over 6 million internally displaced, over 150,000 stateless. We had a war here for 30 years. We know the difficulties. We know the problems we face today. How many people were displaced? How many people were murdered? How many people were killed? So similarly today, same situation has arisen there, and people who have been helping us. Now, what happened in Turkey? They tried their best. They tried very far. Unfortunately, they could not achieve what they wanted. The people of Turkey got together. Today, that country said, why all this? Why all this? The reason is, first, they want the oil, which they have succeeded at the expense of these countries. Then they want these people to be under them. The big countries, they want to sell their weapons. They want to sell their arms and ammunition. But they are not at all worried about the poor children. Today, what is happening? When you go to those countries, you can see how many people are homeless today. How many people are suffering today. If the husband is alive, wife is not there. If there are so many thousands and thousands of young people, they are widows. So all these things, just to get their money, just to get their oil, and just to sell their this thing. Therefore, I think at a time now today, see, take for instance Palestine today. You take Palestine. We as Muslims, you know, we like Mecca, like Medina, the mosque in Mecca and Medina. We have the third biggest mosque is Al-Aqsa in Palestine. Today we are unable to go there. We are unable to go there. Those people of Palestine, the suffering what they have today in their own country they are unable to move about. In their own country they are getting killed. For this, the movement is small. Now when you go through the papers, we can see if a young chap sort of throws a stone at the soldier, he gets killed. Now this is the position. Today we are unable to go into the great Al-Aqsa Mosque. So why all this? Therefore, I think it's a good motion. Our government also must come into this, because what we have faced today, what we have been facing for the last 30 years, should not happen to those countries which are helpful to us, which have been with us when we were in difficulties. When we were short of oil, there were so many countries. Those Arab countries helped us, I can remember. It was these Arab countries which looked after us. And today also they are prepared to help us in all these countries. Therefore, I second his motion and request our government to bring forward this and bring to the big leaders and see that peace comes in Syria. Thank you.
Garo Isha, Kraman Mantrituma.
சபை முதல்வர் அவர்களுக்கு இன்று எங்களுடைய முஜிபுர் ரஹ்மானின் சிரியாவை பற்றி ஒரு பார்லிமெண்டத்துக்கு சம்மதிக்கப்பட்ட விவகாரம் சம்பந்தமாக ஒரு சில வார்த்தைகள் பேசலாம் என்று நினைக்கிறேன். இன்று சிரியா மட்டுமல்ல உலகில் உள்ள முழு அரபு நாடுகளும் அமெரிக்கர்களின் சூழ்ச்சியினால் அந்த மக்கள் துயரப்படுவதை நாங்கள் காணக்கூடியதாக இருக்கின்றது. சிறு வயதில் முதல் மரணிக்கின்ற வயது வரை இன்று மிக துச்சமான நிலையில் உயிர்களை பறிக்கப்படுகின்ற விதங்களை நாங்கள் கவனிக்கக்கூடியதாக இருக்கின்றது. இதற்கு முழு உதாரணமாக 30 வருட காலமாக இந்த நாட்டிலே ஒரு கொடுங்கோலமான யுத்தம் நடைபெற்றது. அதிலிருந்து நாங்கள் அனைவரும் படிப்பினைகளை அறிந்தோம். எங்கள் நாட்டு மக்கள் எவ்வாறு துன்பங்கள் துயரங்களை அனுபவித்தார்களோ அதையும் விட மேலதிகமான துன்பங்களை உலகத்தில் இன்று முஸ்லிம் நாடுகள் அனுபவித்து கொண்டிருக்கின்றார்கள். இவர்கள் என்ன செய்த பாவம்? இவர்கள் ஒரு பாவமும் செய்யவில்லை. அந்த மண்ணிலே உள்ள பெட்ரோல் அதை சூறையாடுவதற்காக வேண்டி பல வித்தியாசமான விதங்களிலே இப்படியான ஒரு திட்டங்களை அவர்கள் இன்று உலக நாட்டுக்கு அறிமுகப்படுத்தி இப்படியான ஒரு கேவலமான செயலில் ஈடுபட்டு கொண்டிருக்கின்றார்கள். இன்று ISS என்று வர்ணிக்கின்றவர்கள் யார்? யூதர்கள். முஸ்லிம்களின் பேர்களை வித்தியாசமாக விற்கின்றார்கள். முஸ்லிம்களுக்கும் ISSக்கும் எந்த தொடர்பும் இல்லை. இறந்த ISS தீவிரவாதிகளை பார்த்தால் முஸ்லிம்களுக்கு ஐத்தியில்லாத சம்பந்தமில்லாத உடம்புகள் பச்சைகள் குத்தப்பட்டு அவர்கள் யூதர்கள் தான், வேறு யாருமல்ல என்பதை இந்த சபையிலே நான் தெரிவித்துக் கொள்ள விரும்புகின்றேன். யாராவது முஸ்லிம்களுக்கும் ISS தீவிரவாதிகளுக்கும் சம்பந்தம் என்று செல்வார்கள் என்றால் அவர்களாக இயற்றி அவர்களால் உருவாக்கப்பட்ட ஒரு கதையை ஒன்றிய இது உண்மையான கதையல்ல. இன்று முழு அரபு நாடுகளும் முழு உலகமும் தீர்மானித்து விட்டது ISS தீவிரவாதி என்பது. அது எங்களுக்கும் முஸ்லிம்களுக்கும் சம்பந்தப்பட்டவர்கள் அல்ல, அவர்கள் யூதர்கள் என்பதை முடிவெடுத்து விட்டார்கள். அதனால் இந்த சபையிலே சொல்லிக்கொள்ள விரும்புகின்றேன், இப்படியான அப்பாவியான சிறுவர்கள் வயோதிபர்கள் பெண்கள் தங்களுடைய மானங்களை இழந்து கொண்டிருக்கின்றார்கள். தங்களுடைய கணவனை இழந்தவர்களாக இருக்கின்றார்கள். பிள்ளை இருக்க தாய் உயிரை பறிக்கப்பட்டவர்களாக இருக்கின்றார்கள். இப்படியான கேவலமான நிலைதான் இன்று நடைபெற்று கொண்டிருக்கின்றது. இப்படியான ஒரு நிகழ்வுகள் நடைபெறாமல் நடப்பதற்கு எங்களுடைய நாட்டில் உள்ள ஜனாதிபதி அவர்களும் பிரதமர் அவர்களும் அவங்களால் இயன்ற முயற்சிகளை செய்ய வேண்டும். அன்று உலக யுத்தத்திலே எங்களுடைய கௌரவ ஜனாதிபதியாக இருந்த JR ஜெயவர்தனா குரல் கொடுத்தது போன்று எங்களுடைய நாட்டின் கௌரவ ஜனாதிபதி அவர்களும் பிரதமர் அவர்களும் இதற்கு குரல் கொடுக்க வேண்டியவராக இருக்கின்றார்கள். நிச்சயமாக கொடுப்பார்கள் என்பதில் எந்த சந்தேகமும் இல்லை. இப்படியான ஒரு நிகழ்வுதான் இன்று உலக நாடுகளில் நடைபெற்று கொண்டிருக்கின்றது என்பதை நான் கருமையான ஒரு கவலையோடு இந்த சபையிலே தெரிவித்துக் கொள்ள வருகின்றேன். அதே போன்று எங்களுடைய நாட்டிலும் இனவாதமும் மதவாதமும் குலவாதமும் ஏற்படாதவாறு இந்த சபையிலே நான் சொல்லிக்கொள்ள விரும்புகிறேன். பல இடங்களிலே இனவாதங்களை மதவாதங்களை குலவாதங்களை ஏற்படுத்துவதற்காக தீய சக்திகள் தற்பொழுது பல முயற்சிகளை செய்து கொண்டிருக்கின்றார்கள். நாங்கள் அறிந்த விடயமாக இருக்கின்றது. ஒரு சிறு தவறை செய்தால் அதை பெருசுபடுத்தி கடந்த ஆட்சி காலத்திலே இனவாதிகளுக்கும் மதவாதிகளுக்கும் குலவாதிகளுக்கும் இந்த நாளை சொந்தமாக கொடுத்து ஒரு பாரிய ஒரு பிளவுகளை இந்த நாட்டிலே மீண்டும் ஒரு இரத்த கலவரத்தை இனவாத கலவரத்தை அன்று தமிழர்களுக்கு ஏற்படுத்தியது போன்று முஸ்லிம்களுக்கு ஏற்படுத்துவதற்கு பல முயற்சிகள் செய்தார்கள். அப்படியான முயற்சியிலிருந்து இதுவரைக்கும் அவருடைய முயற்சி தவிடுபொடியாகிவிட்டது. இதற்கு பிறகும் இந்த சபையில் தெரிவித்துக் கொள்ள விரும்புகிறேன், இப்படியான நிகழ்வுகள் நடைபெறாமல் இந்த சபையில் உள்ள அனைவருக்கும் பொறுப்பாக இருக்கின்றது. அது எனக்கு மட்டுமல்ல, உங்களுக்கு மட்டுமல்ல, இந்த நாட்டில் உள்ள ஜனாதிபதி உட்பட, பிரதமர் உட்பட 225 பாராளுமன்ற உறுப்பினர்களுக்கும் மிக ஒரு பொறுப்புடையவர்களாக செயல்பட வேண்டும். காரணம் என்ன, இந்த நாட்டிலே ஒரு அநியாயமான இன்னும் ஒரு பிரச்சனையான சூழலை உண்டு பண்ணி அவர்கள் இதில் ஒரு வித்தையை உண்டு பண்ணிவிட்டு இதில் ஒரு மகிழ்ச்சி ஏற்படுத்த முனைத்து வருகின்றார்கள். இதை நிச்சயமாக இந்த சபையில் நான் தெரிவித்துக் கொள்ளத்தான் வேண்டும். இப்படியான ஒரு நிகழ்வு இன்றும் நடைபெற்று கொண்டு இருப்பதை நாங்கள் அனைவரும் அறிந்த விடயமாக இருக்கின்றது. அதனால் இன்று உலகத்தில் உள்ள முஸ்லிம்கள் நிம்மதியாக வாழ வேண்டும், அமைதியாக வாழ வேண்டும், அனைத்து இனங்களையும் மதிக்கக்கூடிய ஒரு மார்க்கமாக இஸ்லாமிய மார்க்கம் இருப்பதனால் மற்றவர்களுக்கும் எப்படியான மதிப்புகள் மரியாதைகள் கொடுக்கப்படுகின்றதோ அதே போன்றுதான் அவர்களும் அவர்களுடைய மானங்களை பாதுகாத்து, அவர்களுடைய உயிர்களை பாதுகாத்து, உடைமைகளை பாதுகாத்து, அவர்களும் ஒரு நிம்மதியான சமூகமாக வாழ வேண்டும் என்பதற்காகத்தான் எங்களுடைய கௌரவ முஜிபர் ரஹ்மான் பாராளுமன்ற உறுப்பினர் அவர்கள் இன்று இந்த எஜெண்டாவை இந்த சபையில் சமர்ப்பித்தார். அதற்கு அவருக்கு நன்றி சொல்வனாக சொல்லி நான் விடைபெறுகின்றேன்.
கரு சந்தீப் சமரசிங்க மந்திரித்துமா
மூலாசன கரு மந்திரித்துவனி ஒபத்துமாட்ட ஸ்தூதி வந்தேனவா மட்ட நீ காலைய லபாதீமகன இவகேம அதமே விளாத்திபின கேதவாச்சகன பலனுக்குட்டு அப்பிட்ட மேதே பலனோட மே வர்த்தமானே சிதுவெல்லாம் திபினதே அப்படி அத்தீத்தை கன பொட்டாக் அத்தீத்தை யாயுத்துய் எக்தாஸ் அட்டசியே சிட்ட மகிதான் தேவன லோக சங்கிராமே வெனக்காங் யூரோப்பே ஏகாலே துல யூரோப்பே யுதேவுவன்ட லோக்கு பிரஷ்னியாக் திப்பா தமை யூரோப்பேதி யுதேவுவன்ட பஹரதி மத்தியுனா யூரோப்பே யூரோப்பே ஹிட்டப்பு யுதேவுனா யுதேவுவன்ட ஏஐகே ஏஐட்ட விருத்தவ கிரியாகாரகம் அதிகுண நிசா சரணாகத்தின் ஹட்டியட்ட விஷால பிரிசாக் பலஸ்தீனியட்ட எந்த பட்டாங்கத்தா ஏ பலஸ்தீனியன்ட்ட எந்த பட்டாங்கத்தே கரு மூலாசன மந்திரித்துமணி ஹேத்து அக்திப்பா ஏ மந்த எதா எங்கள் அந்தேட்டாத் பாலன பலையாக் பலஸ்தீனிய திப்பா எம் நிசா ஏ கால பரிச்சேதி பலஸ்தீனியத்தை யுதவுவான் ஆவ அவிலா ஈட பாசே வெஸ்ட் பேங்கக வகை எமன வகையம அனிக் பிரதேச வல பதிந்தியட்ட பதிந்தி வென்ற பட்டாங்கத்த மே துலாத் அராபி கரே எமனத்தான் மெத பெருகது பெருதிக பலஸ்தீனிய பிரஷ்ன அத்தின் என்ற பட்டாங்கத்த இவகையம் அப்படி தன்னவா ஏதா ஒட்டோமன் அதிராஜ்ய தியன காலே ஜெர்மனியிட்ட ஒட்டோமன் அதிராஜ்ய உதவுகருப்பு நிசா ஜெர்மனிய பெத்தகத்த நிசா பிரித்தானிய முகதக்கரே யுனைடெட் அரப் ராஜ்யாக் என்ன எக்ஸட் அராபி ராஜ்யாக் கொடநகண்ட வெனம கட்டியுத்துக்கரா மேத்துலின் தமாய் லிபியாவ டியூனிசியாவ ஏ வகேம அணிக்குத் அராபி ஏ ரட்டவால் பிஹுனே ஏதுலி முனதுனே ஏ ரட்டவால் ஏ விதியட்ட சக்தி மாத்கலும் தெல்வலினும் தொக்கம சக்தி சக்தி மாத்கணும் ஈஜிப்து ஹேம ஏ ஆரா சிதுனுதே அர்த்தமாய் விசேஷன்ம ஏ பாலகேவ் சக்தி மாத்தல ஏகாதிபதி வரும் வெண்ட பட்டாங்கத்த அப்பிதான் ஹொஸ்னி முபாரக் கத்தோ தவறுது கீயா கேரட பாலனை கராது அல் அசாத் கத்தோ தவறுது கீயா பாலனை கராது ஈட பசுவ லிபியாவே கடாஃபி கத்தனங் ஏ தவறுது கணனாவக் ரட பாலனை கரா தமுங்கே தேபல வகே ஏ ரட்டவால் பாவிச்சுக்கிற பசே தமாய் எதா ஏ அத்தியுன ஏ சித்தி நிசா சா ஏ ஜனதாவகே தெரப்பிம் நிசா தமாய் மகஜனதாவ துலிங் மே விதியட்ட மே பிரஷ்னே அத்திவேலா மே சிரியாவே விஷால பிரமாணையாக் ஜனதாவ மே விதியட்ட மியாண்டாத் விசேஷம அப்பி தன்னவா மே விசேஷம தருவான் அப்பி தன்ன விஷால பிரமாணையாக் சரணாகத்தின் ஹட்டிட பத்துலா சிட்டினவா இகனகாண்ட விதிஹாக்னே பாசல் விதிஹாக்னே இவகே லொக்கு பிரஷ்ன வளட்ட மூன பாலா சிட்டினோம் இவகேம அது மேதேதியா பலனகுட்டு அப்பி தெதாஸ் தாய டெசம்பர் தெதாஸ் நெத்தம் தெதாஸ் 11 මුල බලන්න වෙනවා. එමන්ද එදා තමයි ටියුනිසියාවේ අරගලය ඇති වෙලා ටියුනිසියාවේ ඒ මේ ජනාධිපතිවරයාට රටින් පිට වෙන්න පටන් වෙන්න වුණේ. ඒ වගේම ටියුනිසියාවේ ඒ දේ වෙනකොට ලිබියාවේ ප්‍රශ්නයක් ඇති වෙලා ලිබියාවේ නායකයව ජනතාව මරා දැම්ම. ඒ වගේ මේ මෙන්න මේ විදිහට විප්ලවවාදී විදිහට ඉදිරියට ආවා. ඇවිල්ලා ඒ වගේම අපි දැක්ක පංගුවක් රටවල් විශේෂයෙන්ම සිරියාවේ නායකයෝ මොනවද කරේ නායකත්වයට ඉන්න ඕනෑම විදිහට තමුන්ගේ බලය පාවිච්චි කරා. ඒ අය විශේෂයෙන්ම බටහිර ආධාර බලාපොරොත්තු වුණා. අපි දන්නවාද රුසියාව ගිහින් සිරියාවේ ආණ්ඩුවත් එක්ක මොකද කරන්නේ? එකතු වෙලා අර අහිංසක ජනතාව ඉන්න ප්‍රදේශවල බෝම්බ හෙලනවා. ඒ පැතිවල කැරලිකාරයෝ ඉන්නවයි කියලා, අන්තවාදීන් ඉන්නවයි කියලා. එයා ඉන්න පුළුවන්. හැබැයි ඒ තුලින් විශාල හානියක් සිදු වෙනවා ඒ රටේ ඉන්න ජනතාවට. අද දන්නවා සිරියාවේ ජනතාවට යන එනමන් නැහැ. තුර්කියට ගිහින් තිබෙනවා. එහෙම නැත්නම් අනික් රටවල් වලට ගිහින් තිනවා. මං හිතන්නේ මිලියන 3.2ක පමණ මේ මැද පෙරදිග සිටින සරණාගතීන් යුරෝපයේ පැත්තට යන්න කටයුතු කරලා තිබෙනවා. ඉතින් මේ සියලු දේ මේ දේ බලමු. මේකට අපිට කියන්න පුළුවන් විශාල වශයෙන් ඒ රටේ ඉන්න ජනතාව පීඩාවට පත් වෙලා සිටින්නේ. පංගුවක් වෙලාට අපේ දරුවෙක්ගෙන් ප්‍රශ්න ඇහුවොත් මොනවද අවුරුදු පහ තුල මොනවද වෙලා තියෙන්නේ කියලා මැරිච්ච ඥාතින් ගැන පමණයි කතා කරන්නේ. එහෙම නැත්නම් ඒ අයට උඩින්දන් වැටුන බෝම්බ ගැන කතා කරන්නේ. පාසලක් ගැන කතා කරන්න විදිහක් නැහැ. හැබැයි අද මං හිතන්නේ එක්සත් ජාතික UN එක විශාල කාර්යයක් කරනවා මේ රට තුලට මුදල් ගෙනහිල්ලා, එහෙම නැත්නම් ද්‍රව්‍යම ඔය වශයෙන් සහයෝගය දීලා කොහොම හරි මේ අහිංසක සරණාදිකින්ව යම් කිසි තැනකට ගන්න. හැබැයි මීට වඩා කාර්යයක් අපි හිතනවා මේ ලෝකේ ඉන්න නායකින්ට තියෙනවා කරන්න. ඒ මන්ද අපි සෑම විටම කතා කරන්නේ සාමය ගැන. ඒ සාමය කියන එක පිරිසකට පමණක් සීමා වී තු නැහැ. අද මේ සිදුවීම් දිහා බලපුවහම අපිට පේන දෙයක් තමයි මේ වුණේ එදා යුරෝපීය නැත්නම් ගෝලීය පාලන ක්‍රමයක් එදා යුරෝපය ගෙනිච්ච නිසා. නැත්නම් එදා කියන අපි ඒ කාලේ කිව්වා ඩිවයිඩ් ඇන් රූල් කියන එක. ඒ තැනට ගිය හින්දා තමයි අද මේ වගේ තත්ත්වයන් ඇති වෙලා තියෙන්නේ. අප්‍රිකාවේ මේ වගේ තත්ත්වයන් ඇති වෙලා තිබෙන්නේ මේ නිසා. අද අන්තවාදීන් බිහි වෙලා තියෙන මේ නිසා. ඉතින් එම නිසා ඒ වගේම තව දෙයක් තියෙනවා. මෙම යුද්ධයේ කැරලිකාරයන් නැති අද මේකෙන් ප්‍රයෝජනෙ ගන්න ISIS වැනි අන්තවාදීන් මොනවද කරන්නේ? බිහි වෙලා වෙන ඒ කට්ටියගේ කර්තව්‍යයන් ඉටු කර ගන්න කටයුතු කරනවා. එම නිසා අද ගරු මූලාසනුඩ මන්ත්‍රීතුමනි, අපේ ගරු ඇමතිතුමත් ඉන්නවා, විශේෂයෙන්ම අපේ අතිගරු ජනාධිපතිතුමා, ඒ වගේම ගරු රනිල් වික්‍රමසිංහ අගමැතිතුමා විශාල කාර්යභාරයක් මේ රටේ කරලා තිනවා. ජනවාරි 8 එදා මේ සැබෑ වෙනස ගෙනල්ලා රටේ ප්‍රජාතන්ත්‍රවාදය ඇති කරලා මේ රටේ ඒ වගේම සංහිඳියාවක් ඇති කරලා මුළු රටම අද ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ අපේ නායකයෝ පිළි අරගෙන තියෙනවා. එම නිසා මං හිතන්නේ අපේ නායකයන්ගේ වගකීම සහ යුතුකම තමයි අපි දන්නවා ඒ අය ඒ දේ අනිවාර්යයෙන්ම කරනවා මෙම සිරියාවට මේ සාමය උදාකරන්න කටයුතු කිරීම. ඒ වගේම අපි විශේෂයෙන්ම අපි ආණ්ඩුවක් හැටියට අපි මේ පක්ෂ විපක්ෂ හෝ වේවා කවුරුත් වේවා අපි සියලු දෙනාම එකතු වෙලා මෙම ප්‍රශ්නේ නිරාකරණය කිරීමට අපේ පූර්ණ සහයෝගය අපේ නායකින්ටත් ලබා දී යුතුයි කියමින් තමුන්නාන්සේ මට මේ ලබා දුන්න කාලයට හෘදයාගෙන ස්තුතිවන්ත වෙමින් මගේ වචන ස්වල්පය අවසන් කරන ස්තුති.
බොහොම ස්තුති. ගරු හර්ෂිත ශ්‍රීලා ඇමතිතුමා.
Honorable presiding member, let me at the outset thank you for permitting me the floor of this house to share my in my capacity as acting minister of foreign affairs the views of the government on this important adjournment motion moved by honorable Mujibur Rahman member from the Kalamu district seconded by honorable by nationalist member honorable Mohammed Nawawi and also supported by Ishaq, Honorable Member Ishaq Rahman from Anuradhapura and Honorable Sandeep Samarasinghe from Ratnapura. Even though I don't necessarily agree with everything that was said by Honorable Rahman, the origins of ISIS, I don't intend to go into that matter at this point. To get to the substance of Honorable Rauman's adjournment motion, let me tell you that Sri Lanka maintains a long-standing and cordial friendship with the countries in the Middle East. Our relations encompass both people-to-people contacts as well as active measures for mutually beneficial economic and commercial collaborations. Therefore, the prevailing situation in the Middle East region is a matter of serious concern to the government and the people of Sri Lanka. Mr. Chairman, the growing threat of terrorism and radicalism has added to the complexities of the violent situation in the region. The long-standing conflict in the region is the Israeli-Palestine conflict, as mentioned here. That remains strained with the peace talks suspended for over 2 years now. The situation appears to be getting worse as the violence in the region has escalated over the period due to the absence of a credible peace mechanism. Sri Lanka firmly believes that the unresolved issues of Palestine remains a serious threat to international peace, security, and sustainability. Therefore, it is imperative that a comprehensive and a just settlement of the Israeli-Palestine conflict remains a priority of the international community. Mr. Chairman, Sri Lanka's articulated position on Palestine is as follows. Only a negotiated settlement between the parties to the conflict, leading to an independent and democratic state of Palestine based on UN Security Council Resolutions 242, 338, 1397, and 1515, with East Jerusalem as its capital, existing side by side with Israel, could bring peace and stability to the region, unquote. Sri Lanka has since 1968, as chair of the United Nations Special Committee on Israeli Practices Affecting Human Rights of the Palestinian People and Other Arabs of the Occupied Territories, been one of the most significant voices at the United Nations on the subject of the unfortunate conditions of the occupied territories. Sri Lanka also supports Palestine's application for admission as a full member in the United Nations. Sri Lanka strongly believes that the two-state solution is the only viable option for sustainable peace and stability in the region. Therefore, it is the responsibility of the two conflicting parties to ensure that they move closer into a solution rather than moving away from it. Towards this end, Sri Lanka stands with the others in emphasizing that the international community must be firm and consistent in its resolve to assist the people of both sides. Continued commitment of Sri Lanka towards the Palestine cause and Sri Lanka's friendship with the people of Palestine is reflected in the continuous engagement with the Palestinian leadership. Mr. Chairman, escalation of violence in Syria has brought suffering to the Syrian people and seriously affected peace and stability in the Middle East region. According to the UN, the ongoing conflict in Syria has claimed more than 250,000 lives, while over 6 million people have been internally displaced and 4.8 million Syrians have left the country. As a result, Syria now constitutes the largest refugee population in the world, 2.1 million in Egypt, Iraq, Jordan, and Lebanon, 2.7 million in Turkey. Sri Lanka is deeply concerned about the situation in Syria and firmly believes that a political settlement is the only realistic way out of the Syrian crisis. Sri Lanka welcomes the recent peace initiative on Syria, effective from 12 September 2016, initiated by the US and Russia after months of negotiations. Even though the UN was compelled to suspend all its aid convoys in Syria after the devastating attack on its aid convoy near Aleppo on 19 September 2016, we firmly believe that the key players of the Syrian peace process will take appropriate action to strengthen the already initiated peace process when they meet in New York this week on the sidelines of the General Assembly. It may be noted that Sri Lanka voted in favor of the UN resolution on Syria entitled, quote, Situation of Human Rights in the Syrian Arab Republic, unquote, adopted at the UN General Assembly on 23rd December 2015, promoted by Saudi Arabia, Qatar, United Arab Emirates, and co-sponsored by 61 countries. Mr. Chairman, according to the United Nations, over 10,000 people have been killed due to the devastating situation in Yemen during the last 18 months. Over 1 million people have been displaced, and approximately 14 million out of 26 million population need food aid, and 7 million are suffering from food insecurity in Yemen, as earlier mentioned by the Honorable Mujibur Rahman. It is unfortunate that the long-running negotiations to end the conflict in Yemen between the government forces backed by an Arab coalition and Houthi rebels have failed without a solution. Sri Lanka is of the firm belief that all the conflicting parties involved in the devastating situation in Israel, Palestine, Syria, Yemen, Iraq, and other countries in the region should amicably resolve to find consensus-based solutions. Mr. Chairman, Sri Lanka welcomes any efforts that will reinforce and strengthen internal domestic processes and efforts aimed at finding durable solutions to internal crises through international cooperation and dialogue while respecting national sovereignty and independence of the country and its territorial integrity. Sri Lanka is therefore of the view that any measures envisaged by the international community should be constructive and developed in cooperation with the respective countries with a view to enhancing its capacity to resolve the crisis. Therefore, such action thus contemplated should be fundamentally aimed at safeguarding the civilian population. Sri Lanka also urges the respective governments to take all appropriate measures to ensure safety of their civilians. To end, Mr. Chairman, may I once again reiterate with all the emphasis at my command that Sri Lanka desires nothing but the best for the affected people of the Middle East region. We therefore are very clear that the sovereignty, independence, unity, and territorial integrity of the countries affected should be fully respected. Our stance is in full consonance with the principles of non-alignment. It is our fervent hope that peace and stability will be restored in the region at the earliest possible. Once again, I thank Honorable Mujibur Rahman for having brought this adjournment motion and giving us an opportunity to state the official position of Sri Lanka in this context. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Parliament will meet tomorrow at 10:30 a.m.